has to jump to the left.
Thank you.
sky. Give us on the bloodshot street. Oh, damn it, done with a deadly rise. And all I swear I saw a young buck down in the gutter. He was starting to boom and eat. Oh, baby, you're the only thing in this whole world that's pure and good and right.
We'll be right back. the bottom of a pit in the blazing sun. Is my heart still beating? Waking out of my body, finally, like a man I am. Then I'm lying at the bottom of a pit in the blazing sun. All torn and twisted in the blood of a burning flame. And I think tonight it's somewhere must be cold in a bed. And the last thing I see is my heart still beating, breaking out of my body, blind away, like a bat out of hell,
like a bat out of hell, like a bat out of hell,
like a bat out of hell.
Shrapnel hurt, but not the way Patrick imagined. Not a sharp pain, like when he sliced his pinky to the bone chopping tomatoes at his old pizza parlor job, or the time he was exploring old man Feeney's construction site and a two-penny nail punctured his Converse. No, this was more of a burn, as if someone was pressing the business end of a branding iron into his ribs. It hurt like a mother, but Patrick was still better off than his pal, Tennessee Tommy.
Years and I ain't got nothing but
right world, wrong time, and they say to me, ain't cruel teddy bear.
Oh, On TV. Dried up chewing gum, discarded fast food wrappers on the sidewalks, too much noise, too much pollution from the endless stream of cars cruising up and down the strip. An army of costumed lunatics on every corner. Patrick Fish. sneaked right in. Dried blood caked on his face, a brown paper bag clutched in his left hand, a makeshift bandage wrapped around his right eye. He paused to admire something in the store window, a panorama of a movie that was coming out. It looked crappy, corny, probably the kind Jenny would like. You could take the country out of the girl, he mused. That looks really bad, doesn't it? He heard her remark. But when he turned, she was nowhere to be seen.
Now, you hear it? Sydney, I wrote you this poem, and I'd like to dedicate it to you.
I'm just a white boy. I beat a guitar. I put my pants on. I drive a shit car. I've been to the Mary to see my girlfriend. She got a big couch. She got a Mercedes-Benz.
Sing hallelujah.
My glass is half full. She bought me champagne. She drinks a Red Bull. And she said, darling, one thing you got to understand.
As long as I am satisfied, then you will always be my man.
You know that I give you all the love, yeah. I'll empty out my pockets. I'll give you what I can. You know that I'll give you all the love that I have. I'll give you all the love that I have. Los Angeles,
disrespect to any of you men out there, but check this out. I say this with the deepest appreciation for all you ladies out there, especially the ones who've shown a little love for someone such as myself. You see, you believe in me. Ooh, the love, man.
On a hot summer night, would you offer your throat to the wolf with the red rose in it?
Will he offer me his mouth?
Yes.
Will you offer me his teeth?
Yes.
Will he
Yes.
And will he starve without me?
Yes.
And does he love me?
Yes.
Yes.
On a hot summer night, would you offer your throat to the wolf with the red roses?
Yes.
I bet you say that to all the boys.
I see that some of you brought your leg of lamb and your bottle of Chianti. But I'll tell you what I see. I look out at this audience and I see the mighty. I see the mighty. I see see the mighty people of Sydney, Australia. I see the mighty people from the suburbs of the city of Sydney, Australia. Patricia. Now, Patricia says to me, Meatloaf. Well, actually, she just says meat. She said, I would expect that people with that much heart and that much soul in their bodies and that much drive, that they should live in the mighty, mighty, mighty city of Sydney, Australia. They would be standing on their feet. This song is called Stand in the Storm.
Some days it don't come. Some days it don't come.
Will you help me down? Will you get-
Johnny.
Inside of me, baby, we can ride all night, all night. Oh, my Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, before I do anything else, I have to introduce to you right now, Jenny. Where are you, darling? She is 20 years old. Her name is Jenny Luke. And until she came into the band just recently, this young man over here was our baby. Not anymore. He is 28 years old. He is Mr. Justin Avery. And I have known Mr. Jim Steinman for so long that Jim, if he would have been here tonight and he would have been sitting down there in that front row, he would have been on his feet screaming at the top of his lungs for what you just saw.
Well, there's only one girl I'll never know. That was so many years ago. And though I know I never get her out of my heart, never love him back. Ooh, I know. Well, I remember how she left me on a stormy.
If you will, I would like to say this to all the fans that have been here since 1978 and beyond. You are the true fans. You are steadfast. You are loyal. And we all love you deeply. And if you would allow me, thank you for being here tonight in Sydney, in this building, with this band, with me, and with you. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. I don't know if you noticed, but there's cameras running around. So if you want to be known as Sydney, Australia, who sits on your ass on a DVD, go right ahead. And if you want to, I think it's time to party! No rhythm. You see, I'm on the road all the time and my wife is at home and I'm in my room alone. So I've recorded this music so that when it plays in my room, I get to fantasize about Deborah. Woo! Doggy! One hot mama! Grandma magazine.
tonight. We're gonna go all the way tonight, tonight.
We're gonna go all the way tonight.
We're gonna go all the way tonight, tonight.
Over, okay? Just two adults separated by many feet. Dear, I called you up like a respectful gentleman. I came to your house. I picked you up like a respectful gentleman. I brought you flowers, I brought you candy, I walked you out to the car, I opened the door to the car, I let you in, I closed the door like a respectable gentleman. Right? Did I do that?
Okay.
Okay. So,
my little bitty buttercup, my little yellow rose, my little bitty Holland tulip. This is our first date.
My little bitty sweetheart.
Oh, God.
Darling, honey bun, a little bit bigger than a tulip. You're 64 years old. I might not get a second date out of you. Well, what's it gonna be, boy? Yes or no? What's it gonna be, boy? Yes.
I'm not gonna look over there. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no. Okay. Okay. Listen, men, I know you're not going to like this. I don't like it, but it's the truth. Sometimes we just have to deal with the truth. And the truth is this: if you're dating, if you're in a relationship, if you're married, if your boss is a woman, and anything comes up
that you think that you might want to disagree with, don't. Hold it. Let me explain the reasoning behind that. Because, men, if you want to be happy in your life, the woman is always right. Oh, I know there's some men out there cursing me up and down. But trust me, you'll learn. All right, I have broken also the second rule of relationships. You never, ever, ever make a woman cry. I can't believe I have to do this. Patricia?
What?
I am very, very, very sorry. Sexiest man on this stage, Randy Nashville Flowers. On keyboard, saxophone, and vocals, he wants to move to Thank you.
Good time, bro.